this is a busy week for the Eagles in terms of building depth on this roster. That's why today the Eagles signed LaRaven Clark.
Yep, the cowboy, Mr. McClain. You Americans are all alike. But this time, John Wayne doesn't walk into the sunset with Grace Kelly.
It's Gary Cooper, asshole.
Happy trails, Hans.
Dallas still stinks. You're right, the way, King Dingbat here, and I hope everybody's having a great Mother Hump Day. I hope you guys are doing well. So this week has really turned into the week for the Eagles to add to their roster depth. They've been adding depth pieces all week. Today is no exception as they add another offensive lineman. And we're going to get into it in a second, but a few things first. One, Dingbat Nation has invaded TikTok, Mother Humpers. We have invaded it. We are growing tremendously fast. If you haven't, click the link in the description and go give me a follow over there. It's a little different over there. You only have like 59 seconds to talk, so you have to talk real fast. But I'm going to have fun nonetheless. Got a lot of ideas for it. So if you haven't, follow me over there. You won't be disappointed because we're taking over TikTok, Mother Humpers. Second thing, I am Ruiz. Shout out to you, a long-time subscriber, a long-time follower. And I just wanted to take a second to wish his daughter, Yana Lee, a happy birthday. She turned 4 years old yesterday. He watches the channel with her many times, so we just wanted to give her a shout out and wish her a happy fourth birthday. Happy birthday to you, and I hope I said the name right. One other thing, 5:30 Eastern, 2:30 Pacific, me and Deanna Tana talking sports. While he's not banned from SeaWorld at this very moment, he is going to come on and we are going to discuss Eagles versus Giants. I want to hear his take. He doesn't really understand, I think, why we think Jalen Hurts could be good and why the Eagles can compete for the division. So hopefully we'll be able to have a good discussion about that. I always love having Chris on, so it'll be fun. And my invitation to Mark Holmes still stands. I'm just waiting for confirmation. I'm waiting for him to come out and say, yes, I will come on Thursday, and we can go at it, we can discuss it, and all those kind of things. Mark, we're just waiting for you to confirm. But as for today, the entertainer, talking sports, 2:30, it'll be fun. Look out for that. Now, let's get into the Eagles. The Eagles today, they made another signing. Really, if you look at all week, it's been all about the depth moves. Even Ryan Kerrigan, bringing him in, I thought was a depth move. I don't know that he's going to start. If he does start, he's going to beat out who? Derek Barnett. But I really see him as a rotational piece. Josiah Scott, they traded for yesterday. The Eagles have been adding to the depth of this team, okay? And that's a good thing. I do think you're going to see some bigger signings come after June 1st. Once that Alshon Jeffrey money clears, that Malik Jackson money clears, once they figure out what to do with Zach Ertz, I do think the Eagles are going to make a move for another corner. I really believe they're going to try to get a second corner in there to be a starter opposite of Darius Slay. But we're going to find out. I mean, really, this is, when it comes to the defensive backs, it's really all about Jonathan Gannon. Can he develop these defensive backs? Can he develop a guy like Scott who has some potential? What about McPherson, who they drafted? So it's going to be interesting. But today the Eagles went out and they addressed the offensive line. Now they did sign Casey Tucker yesterday for the fourth stint. Today they go out and they sign LaRaven Clark. The offensive tackle was with the Indianapolis Colts. I don't know ton about the guy, so I'm going to read what they have here. They said Clark, 28 years old, has experience, played while Nick Sirianni was there, so he knows Nick Sirianni. He was drafted in the third round, number 82 overall by the Colts in the 2016 draft. He has made 15 starts in 47 career games, mainly serving as a swing tackle for Indy. So Clearly, LaRaven Clark, the Eagles bring him in. Clearly, he is fighting for a backup role. He's going to be fighting for a backup role, and it's going to be interesting to see how this whole tackle situation pans out, because you have Andre Dillard and Jordan Mulata. Clearly, they are in a battle for that left tackle position. They have to be, right? Lane Johnson, he is secure. And then I would say Jordan Mulata's probably got the advantage over Andre Dillard. But Andre Dillard's a first-round pick. He's got to develop. Could LaRaven Clark be a guy they're bringing in as a backup, hoping that maybe they trade Andre Dillard down the road? That's a possibility. I would not be surprised if the Eagles trade Andre Dillard at some point, or at least try to move him into guard. But LaRaven Clark, he signs with the Eagles. He is a backup. And, you know, I have no problem with this move in terms of, you know, bringing a guy in for depth. The issue with LaRaven Clark is he is coming off an Achilles injury. We don't even know when he's going to be ready. So, I mean, that's not the greatest thing in the world, to have another guy coming back from an injury who we don't know when he's going to be healthy. But the Eagles are bringing him in probably mainly because of his connections with Nick Sirianni. But this week has been a week of building depth on this roster with some young guys, with some young talent. As far as Raven Clark goes, I see him as a backup practice squad. No, maybe not practice squad guy, but at least a guy that's going to play snaps and get snaps during preseason. Maybe just another body. Maybe he wins a backup role. But it's going to be interesting, because I really don't know what they're going to do with Andre Dillard. To me, that's the key piece. If you have Landon Dickerson, right, I assume, let's say he's healthy, he could play. What the hell is that banging out there? I don't know what these guys are. They're building like crazy out there, man. You should see, like, in like 2-3 days, they got all the frames up on all these houses. I'll show you later. But anyway, so, you know, you got Landon Dickerson. He's coming back from injury. Is he going to be a center, or is he going to be moved to guard? I would keep him at center. I would let him just sit and learn behind Kelce. Learn from the best, okay? Yes, I am Jason Kelce. That is true. And I just got finished my Eagles press conference. A quick shave, and here we go. But no, Dickerson is a guy that I would definitely leave at center. You have Isaac Seumalo. You have Brandon Brooks coming back, Lane Johnson. And then I think that left tackle is an open battle. LaRaven Clark, he's a backup. But the question is, what's going to happen with Dillard and what's going to happen with Mulata? I think there's your battle at the offensive line position. So with that said, LaRaven Clark is signed with the Eagles. And let me know what you guys think. I will see you guys 5:30 Eastern time with the Entertainer Talking Sports. With that said, take care. Talk to you later. Of course, don't be a dingbat. You know, when I moved in here, all this was empty. It was all empty. And within 3 days, they framed all these houses. It's kind of crazy, right? Kind of crazy. I liked it when there was no houses built. It was nice and quiet. I enjoyed my nights. Now, I gotta look at all these people's houses. I hope they're not Cowboy fans or Giant fans. I'm sure they're not Washington fans, because that's a team without a name. But hey, the neighborhood's going up in flames already.